Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Asterix Solution, and as we are continuing with our series of JavaGyan, this is our video on how inheritance actually works. So the previous video we saw how you can, what inheritance was, what were the types of inheritance, and this video we are actually going to implement it practically, see how it affects your memory allocation and all the other stuff related to inheritance. So starting off with, let's dive into the concept and write a simple inheritance class and see how it works. So what I'm going to do here is just writing a simple class A, let's say, and in my class A I'm going to write a method public void m1, and in my public void m1 I'm just going to say system.out.println a-m1, and I'm just going to store this. So let's store this, and yep, so I store this here, a.java. So I have stored my class a.java. I have compiled this, so it's compiled fine. As you can see, it's taking time to compile. Okay, it's compiled. So let's go and write a subclass. So this is basically my super class. I need to write a subclass. So I say class B. You know the keyword for writing, extending a Java class is extend. And I want to write the name of my class, super class. So I wrote the name, and now what I'm doing, public void m2, and I say system.out.println b-m2, and I save this file again. So it's b.java. I compile this. Okay, I made a small mistake. I should have stored this file in another folder where my class A was. So I just go in my class here and try to save this and replace the old file I had, and I compile this now. Okay, so the file is compiled. Now if I want to write a demo class, I'll have to just write a new Java file, let's say demo public static void main, and as I have inherited in my class B, it will be easier to understand that b is equal to new B, and b.m1 will be accessible to me because I have inherited it. B.m2 will again be available to me because I have inherited it. So I store my class demo now, and I replace this, and I just save it, compile it, and let's run this. So if you see, I am running the class object of class B. Because of inheritance, data from super class came down to subclass. Now just try to understand this thing in a theoretical way. When I wrote the class A was belonging to, it was a simple super class. When I wrote class B, it became the subclass of class A, and eventually all the data from super class came down to the subclass. So as you can see right now in the memory graph, what you can see is when I wrote the class A only had data by itself, but when I wrote class B eventually got the data from class A. This is what inheritance does to you. Inheritance is a process through which object of subclass acquires the state and behavior of its superclass. So using this way, your inheritance work and memory graph work. Now if you want, you can include one more class in the inheritance here. For now, your current series goes like A is the superclass, B is the subclass. You want, you can add one more, just add a new class. Let's say class C, and what you have to do is extends B. You can extend it to B and just say public void m3 system.out.println, and you just say here c-m3. I save it, and I say c.java. I compile this, it's compiled. Now if in my class demo I say c is equal to new C, and I just say c.m1. So as C was the least subclass, the last one in the hierarchy, I will get data from A as well as from B now. So it goes c.m2, c.m3. Save it, compile. So if I run this now, you can see first with the object of B, A got called, then B got called. Now with object of C, of data method from A was called, B was called, and again from C was called. So with inheritance, you can understand that data from superclass comes down to you. You can increase the reusability. You don't have to write that data again and again. So this is how inheritance works. Do like and subscribe to our channel if you like the videos, and do share it with your friends. Thank you.